The majority of people are aware that money is an emotional subject, but few are aware that this is also the reason why they usually end up making poor choices. Morgan Housel provides all the information we need to understand how to avoid these emotional pitfalls in his book, The Psychology of Money. I will share the 6 key lessons I discovered in this video, and by the time it is over, maybe you will be able to control your emotions better. Let's get to it. First lesson, wealth is something you cannot see. In one of his stories, Morgan describes a man who drove a Porsche to the hotel where he worked. To his amazement, the same man returned in an old automobile a week later. It turns out that the man had a sizable debt from purchasing the car, and when he experienced financial difficulties, he was forced to sell it. Instead of wanting to be wealthy, this man obviously preferred to appear wealthy. Let us examine the distinction. Typically, we use what we see to determine a person's wealth. Like the man in the story, when we see someone driving a nice car, we automatically think they are wealthy. However, the only thing we're certain of is that he has less than $100,000 to spend. He would have $100,000 more if he had kept the cash and driven a conventional car instead. And what makes us wealthy is having money that we can use. There is nothing wrong with having a pricey automobile or other pleasures if you can afford them, but if buying things is more important to you, you may be more interested in appearing wealthy than actually being wealthy. And the quickest way to have less money is to spend money to demonstrate to others how much you have. Lesson 2, money buys you freedom. The saying money cannot buy happiness is one that we have all heard. And while we may agree or disagree with it, I believe we can all agree that having control over how we allocate our time is more valuable than anything money can buy. One of the things that brings the most enjoyment is the ability to do what we want, when we want, with the people we want, regardless of our wage or the status of our position. And if we are wealthy enough, we can all enjoy that pleasure. But money can buy us more than just that. It can also give us choices. People who struggle to make ends meet cannot afford to miss a few days of work due to illness, since it could result in them not having enough money to cover their expenses. People with few funds do not have much time to look for a new job if they get fired, so they may end up with a stressful job they do not like. Those who have 6 months' worth of expenses set aside are not afraid of their boss, since they are aware that if they take some time to hunt for another job, they will not lose everything. And others with even more resources can manage to work flexible hours for a smaller wage. Saving money provides us with more and better options, which gives us greater control over our lives. Lesson 3, it is more important to be reasonable than rational. This lesson stands out among the others in the book as the most important, in my opinion. We often choose the option we think would produce the best outcomes when, in reality, we should choose the one that will allow us to sleep better at night. I will explain. Steve, a buddy of mine, has $5,000 to start investing. Although it is a substantial amount of money for him, he is optimistic that it will go well and that he will not need the money if he loses. He believes that now is the best time because the market has been booming lately. He has 2 choices. Option 1 is to invest everything and wait for the market to expand. Option 2 is to invest $500 every month for 10 months. Option 1 sounds more enticing to him since, in his opinion, the market will expand swiftly and it would be foolish to pass up the chance. And he acts in that manner. The market crashed 1 week later. Since a few days ago, Steve has been in a panic and is unable to glance at the app. Later, he makes the decision to sell and loses half of it. A few years later, Steve makes the decision to try once more and opts for strategy 2. He spends $500 within the first month. After the market plummeted a month later, he lost a third of his first investment, but he was not concerned because he still had money, so he bought 500 more. When the market rises, he makes money, but when it falls, he buys more for less money. He sees it as a win-win position. He is aware that his revenues are not as high as they may be, but the fact that he is currently sleeping well is far more significant. Lesson 4, nothing is free. Every investment we make comes with a hidden cost, and contrary to what you might expect, that cost is not financial. Rather, it is an emotional one, such as tension, doubt, or anxiety. The issue is that we usually are unaware of it until it is time to pay. So rather than seeing it as an expense we must pay in exchange for the benefit, we see it as a fine and oppose it. The remedy is to become aware of the fees we must pay for each investment and to be prepared to do so when the time comes. Let me give you an example. I know a guy named John who purchased a Bitcoin for $7,500 some time ago. John had faith in the concept of Bitcoin and decided to commit a sizable amount of money. He was first quite pleased with his decision as Bitcoin doubled to $15,000. But a few months later, it began to decline for an entire year, eventually reaching a low of $2,500. John was hurt. He cried inside every time he opened the app to check the price of Bitcoin. His legs tremble every 10% dip. John questioned his decisions and whether he should sell what was left on multiple occasions, but he continued, and 3 years later, Bitcoin slowly recovered and hit a new high of $55,000, giving John a newfound sense of assurance. Now it seemed simple. All he had to do was wait and buy it. But John was not prepared for the high emotional cost that came with his achievement. Always keep in mind that there is a cost associated with investing. View it as a charge rather than a penalty. Lesson 5. Play to win. Meet two potential investors. The first is a father with a good career who is seeking for a means to put his funds to use and build wealth over the next years. He is referred to as the long-term investor. The second is a man in his mid-20s who recently started working and has plenty of spare time to browse the markets. To make a little more dollars, he enjoys doing some trading every day. He is referred to as the short-term investor. Stocks that are increasing are beloved by short-term investors. By purchasing and then selling at a higher price a few hours later, he typically turns a rapid profit. Companies that the long-term investor thinks will be successful in the future are those he prefers. And many times, those companies are the same ones the short-term trader just put money into. As a result of both investors' participation, the trend will continue to attract more and more people until it eventually collapses. The short-term investor avoids the crash by entering and exiting before it happens. However, the long-term investor bears the loss because he has no immediate plans to sell. In real life, this frequently occurs when trending stocks draw an increasing number of day traders, which drives up the price. Mid-term and long-term investors are drawn to these results and fail to recognize that other investors are involved in alternative strategies. They regret it when the crash occurs. Although they will likely make money in the long term, they are currently suffering emotionally, which is the fine we discussed in the previous session. Therefore, be cautious of those from whom you seek advice, as they may not be participating in the same game as you. Lesson 6. Allow for room for error. Rick, a buddy of mine, never exercised financial restraint. He never bothered about conserving money and constantly spent his paycheck on trips and drinks. He put $1,000 into Bitcoin as it started to rise. After a few years, Bitcoin struggled, although it had grown 5 times since then. I ran into him one day and inquired about his investment because by this point, he ought to be making a nice profit. However, he said that he had to sell it for half the price in order to pay for a motorcycle. Rick could have had 5 times more right now, but he had to sell at an inconvenient time since he had no money. You should always leave space for error in your plans since the world is unpredictable. Why not increase it to 9 months if you believe that 6 months is adequate? In order to buy a house in 2 years, increase your monthly savings by 20%. If you have the money you need early, that is excellent. If not, you will be happy you had a bit extra put up because the price you expect to pay can be greater. You should always add a safety buffer to prevent disappointment. I highly recommend reading the book if you want to learn more because it is really simple to read and contains 20 interesting lessons in addition to these 6.